Only 3 years ago, Ireland voted in favour of same-sex marriage and became the first country in the world to do so by popular vote. Now, Ireland is set to hold a referendum on arguably the most bitterly contested issue in modern Ireland, abortion. Here's a report.
I hope the people in Ireland will remember the fate of our daughter Savita.
This is Savita Halappanavar's father urging the public to remember his daughter and vote yes in the abortion referendum in Ireland on this Friday. Savita was a 31-year-old Indian origin dentist who died at University Hospital Galway in 2012 after a septic miscarriage. Her miscarriage went on for days, but the hospital staff refused to provide any medical aid to speed up the end of her pregnancy. The reason? The Eighth Amendment of Ireland's constitution recognizes the right to life of the unborn and says the state will defend and vindicate that right. In short, abortion in Ireland is illegal. And while Savita's miscarriage was inevitable, her death was not. After news of her death was made public, protests and vigils were held across Ireland calling for changes to Ireland's strict abortion laws. The people of the country are split into two camps, the Yes campaigners and the No campaigners. Yes campaigners focus on women's rights and the medical dangers they say are created by the constitutional ban.
I believe that abortions are happening in Ireland and all across the world regardless of what the law is. So, you know, we have to make sure that everybody who needs to have an abortion is able to do so safely.
The No campaigners, on the other hand, argue that if laws are liberalised, it would become an abortion on demand service.
We need to rally together as a society and say to women that you're stronger than abortion. You can do this. That you have the potential to go on and live a normal life, and that a baby doesn't have to get in the way of that.
Just ahead of the vote, brightly coloured slogans are witnessed across the country. Stop shaming women and license to kill are just some of the posters that people in Ireland walk past every day. And as the country gears up for the first opportunity in 35 years to overhaul one of the world's strictest abortion laws, it looks like the vote could swing either way. Bureau Report, WION.